Hello and welcome to a brand new quick tip by JANUS Engineering. I often hear from customers that moving around in a large assembly within Siemens NX might be kind of difficult. So what is the best way to move around in a virtual space? Today I will show you how to reposition the so-called rotation reference in a flash. At the end of the video, you will even find another very helpful quick tip, so stay tuned. Off we go with my colleague Alex.
As you can see, there's a big assembly displayed that we are going to be working on today. When we move the machine around, we can get a good impression of how big this milling machine actually is. But when we zoom into the part, we can notice that the part is quite small compared to the size of the machine itself. When we are zoomed into the part, what happens when we want to rotate it? Well, the part rotates, but so does the machine along with it. And most of the time, this becomes an issue of the machine getting in the way to view the part itself. This is because the rotation point that is naturally set in NX. This is set to the middle of the assembly. So how can we change this? Well, we can right-click into the empty space within the graphics box, and then we can select Set Rotation Reference. By doing this, we can then select any surface or point on the part to become our new rotation reference, meaning that NX is going to rotate around that specified area. When we rotate the assembly now, we can see that the rotation is much more controlled, and we have a much better visual of the part itself. The only downside of using this method is that we have to change this reference point consistently. Say we want to use the machine itself as a rotation center, then we need to repeat this process. We'll right-click, select Set Rotation Reference, and then select the surface or point. Just like that, there is a new rotation reference. We can always go right back and click and clear our rotation reference as well, bringing it back to the natural center of the assembly for NX. So what's another option? Let's zoom back into the part. Using your mouse, click the middle mouse button down and wait for a second. Now we see our mouse symbol changes and the exact point where it was at is now the new referent point for us. When moving around, we can once again see that the machine itself is not disturbing our view of the part. We can try it again on the part over here. Just like that, we have a new reference rotation point. And if we zoom out and select an area on the machine, we can do that just as easy. So that is the first quick tip of the day. Now, like we mentioned earlier, I would like to begin the second one. For the second tip, what if I just want to move one portion of my assembly? We select Move and the part, and then once we do this, we have a dialog box that pops up for us to enter coordinates. But this might disturb us a little bit when working. Well, we can select the box and move it out of the way. And now we're free to move around the coordinate system as we want. There's another easier way to do this. Let's jump back into the move option for our part. The dialog box pops up. Another way to get this out of our way is just to click the F3 button on your keyboard. This makes the dialog box just disappear, and then we can go again and move the coordinate system freely. For this specific move, this trick might not be that big of a deal. But if we were to open this curve drive operation over here, there are quite a few more dialog boxes that pop up. For example, the drive method has a bunch of drive sets that are defined. What if we want to create a new drive set? All the current drive set dialog boxes are in the way, making it difficult to select our drive curve. When we click F3 here, now all of our dialog boxes disappear and we can select exactly what we need to. If we hit the F3 key again, the actual dialog box itself will collapse. And if we hit the F3 one more time, everything reappears. So again, that's F3, F3, and F3, and those are our options.
Thanks, Alex. We don't need to care how big our assembly is in NX anymore, since we can place the rotation reference as we wish. Thus, we no longer have any difficulties with moving around in virtual space. Feel free to leave a like and a subscription so you don't miss our future videos. We look forward to your feedback in the comments below. Did you know about these two tips? Maybe you can think of another topic you'd like to hear a tutorial about. See you next time. Bye.